Hi there! In the last video we finished with this question in mind, so what can we do with non-important features? So today I'm going to talk about feature selection, or better say, automatic feature selection. So let me summarize the main ideas, and this is going to be really useful for you. So these 5 tips should be part of your machine learning workflow. So the first tip is trust your eyes, and sometimes some numbers like correlation. Nothing can trump a good visual like this one, so here clearly Y doesn't depend much on X1, but sometimes having some numbers is good, and we discussed this function filter variable importance from Carrot library. The second idea is that you should standardize your inputs. This is very simple in Carrot. You only have to pre-process that. And I would say that not just center and scale. Remember that when you have very skewed distributions, and I'm going to talk about that later in the video, just to use another transformation, not only subtracting the mean and divided by the standard deviation, but some methods like the Box-Cox transformation. Number three, some of the methods like partition trees and or decision trees and random forests have implemented inside some variable important metrics. So use those and not use just one, compare different methods. And tip number four, when you don't have simple correlations or when you want to have an idea of the overall sensitivity of the output to the input, use specific libraries for machine learning. In this case, for neural network, you have this very nice sensitivity analysis method. And tip number five is the best of all, is combine different methods, not just to stick to these four ideas. Fit different methods like random forests, trees, support vector machines, neural networks, and make your own mind comparing those methods. Okay, so let's go back to the question. What can we do with non-important features? The answer is very simple, remove them. But how can we remove them? So there are a couple of approaches. The first one is called the wrapper methods. In this case, you evaluate multiple models and you discuss what happens when we are systematically adding or removing features. And we're going to discuss a couple of ways to do that. For instance, you have a model with n inputs. So one method is starting with all of them and remove one, see how this performs, and then iterate, removing x2 or x1 and so on and so forth. And then you have a clear picture of relative importance of each of the variables. Okay, this is very costly because when you remove the next variable, you have to compute everything again, the training, the testing, and so on and so forth. But this is the safest way to compare models. Okay, the idea of this is that you can find the optimal combination that maximizes performance with the least number of variables. The second approach is something that we have covered, not with this name, but it's very simple, is try to evaluate predictors according to how they good are working in a given method. So this means that before trying to fit any model, you can compute correlations or sensitivity analysis. This is the ones that we have tested. These are called filter methods because this, in this case, in the case of correlation, you are using logistic regression, and in the case of sensitivity analysis, you're using neural networks, and this is a kind of filter that is going to tell you what variables are not relevant, okay? The third way is pre-processed numerical values, specifically numerical values, and you can do this using model-independent metrics like correlations, and we're going to discuss in a few weeks principal component analysis, which is an automatic way to combine parameters and to remove spurious correlations. And of course, nothing trumps external validation. So forget about all the theory that me and somebody else is going to tell you. There is nothing like using common sense. So again, a good visual is better than a good method. Here you have some keywords in this field of feature extraction. And I'm going to discuss a little bit this part here. And I strongly recommend you this book by the guy who created the Carrot library, Max Kuhn. Not only he's a genius because he created Carrot, he's also a genius because this book is really comprehensive, very practical. You have a lot of R codes there, so I strongly recommend that book. And if you read that book, in the last part of the book, actually I think it's the last chapter, he discusses a couple of ways to remove features. One category is called automatic forward selection, and the idea of forward is very simple. So start with one predictor, and then you add another one, and another one, and another one, and you update the model each time you include a new feature. Okay, so basically you compare how significant is the new feature according to the previous one. Of course, you have to randomize this inclusion because the way in which you start is going to affect the outcome. This is not very used these days. What is more useful is what they call the backward selection, and one algorithm is recursive feature elimination, or RFE. And the idea is the following: you start with all of the variables, and then you rank them according to importance. If the algorithm, for instance, is random forest, and then you have implemented this variable importance feature, then you have this ranking, and then you can cut the ranking, you can remove, for instance, the last one, and then repeat over and over again. And you keep the most important ones, run the process, create a new ranking, and iterate until the number, the prediction is good enough with the less number of features. So I'm going to stop the presentation and go to our studio and show you how this can work.